The mother of the daughter who was denied admittance into the Mohawk Correctional Facility last year. We had them on the air. It was a bit of an interesting story. And now we get an update. Michelle, thanks for coming on. Good morning.
Good morning.
So if you could pick up and not be on speaker, if that's possible. It does work with our system here in a negative way. But either way, can you give us an update?
Yes, we attempted a second visitation on January 15th. And we, believe it or not, wore the same exact outfit and had the same guard, and we were allowed in. There's one difference with Sierra that we did. We added a floor-length sweater jacket so that even covered the pants and already the extra-long shirt.
Okay.
Unfortunately, it's just... It's unimaginable because on radio you can't show them the outfit. And we've had a mixed feedback as well on Facebook. Oh, they must have changed clothing because there's nothing wrong. Or some would say, oh, that is really terrible because we've come such a long way and see him.
Yeah, by the way, if you don't know, you guys are coming from Gloversville area?
Yeah.
Yeah. I did the last time we were on. We didn't understand why you couldn't be let in. It seemed like the clothing, the attire seemed pretty conservative.
Actually, we're a very conservative family in nature, and Sierra doesn't even wear tight pants outside of the home, other than when she's working out. You know, she wouldn't even go to the Y that way. So it's really not a matter of dress code. I think the real problem is it's an abuse of power on the guard's behalf.
Did you ever file a complaint?
We didn't file a complaint. We just let them know, hey, if we're going to attempt a second time, if we attempt a second time and get the same difficulty, then we were definitely going to file a complaint and possibly get a lawyer.
Okay. Do you think that maybe someone spoke to that employee?
I'm sure they did, and when they said that her superior was asked, you know, what was the difficulty, the superior's answer was, this guard did what she was supposed to do. Now, as people are coming, going to the visitation room, I've known strolls of different people coming back after their process, and they hadn't gotten in also, and I said, why aren't you let in? And it's for the same reason.
Yeah.
And... You would hear also, the captain came out one time while we were halfway through and said, I don't know what your problem is, but half of the people getting in there are dressed inappropriately in the leggings and very tight, provocative clothing. And the person who was let in right before Sierra was very provocative, very skin tight. You could see every inch of her, very curvy. And then to say my daughter's inappropriate. And I have to say, I even worked for Albany County Jail, which I said to them, listen, you know, I've been a nurse at Albany County Jail. I know what's appropriate. I know what is not. I know what is acceptable. I said, we are as conservative as it gets from the turtleneck to the toes. There's no reason why you should be not letting her in.
Yeah.
And did they give you, I can't remember, did they give you a reason? Did they say it's too tight, it's too loose, she's showing too much skin?
They just said that the upper portion of the thigh was too tight, even though if you noticed her shirt covered below her bottom. And I would say roughly if you put your hand above your knee, that's the only part of her that was showing.
Okay.
As far as tightness was concerned.
So,
and then the captain was out that day. I said, I need to speak with the captain then. And they said, well, he's not here. It's Sunday. I said, okay, well, whoever your superior is, let me speak to them, please. And when he came out, he said, I'm not saying she's dressed inappropriate. I'm only going to say whatever she says as the guard is what's going to happen.
Well, and you can't blame, I guess, you're going to stand by your employees and then deal with it afterwards.
Right.
It is a shame that you guys are the victims. Interestingly, you worked in the prison system. You were an employee
of
the correction system in New York State. So you have a little more insight than the average person. Somebody brought up this, and I'm not sure that this is appropriate, but somebody had brought up the fact that maybe the inmate did something that disallowed you entering on that day. Have you considered that, or do you believe that's something possible?
Oh, absolutely not. In fact, he's been absolutely a wonderful inmate, and he just moved to the honorable dorm.
Okay, all right. Well, perplexing, but it seems like whatever the reason for you not to get in has changed. They're letting you in now, so That would be a positive.
It's definitely a positive. Sierra went approximately 5 months without seeing her father.
Wow.
I have to say, as far as Facebook was concerned, some of the comments were, why should she be allowed visitation? There isn't in a cemetery. And, you know, just to touch base on DWI. You have many people that do poker runs that are drinking every weekend. Mm. And I have to say, for my ex-spouse, he never did any of that. So it does make me feel bad because this happened at a restaurant at 2:30 in the afternoon where he and his best friend went out to lunch, had drinks, had rum and cokes, and it was not even a minute and a half from the restaurant where the accident occurred.
Mm. Boy, it makes you all of us should makes us all think about it. And now they're talking about lowering the alcohol to 5.05%. The blood alcohol content, which would make that a DWI if that were to go into play. But God forbid someone gets hurt. That's just terrible. Was there someone deceased in this accident?
Yes, it was. They were traveling in a 68 convertible Corvette, and it was a 90-degree day, and they were both ejected out of the vehicle.
Yeah, wow.
And one was dead on, the best friend was dead on impact. You know, but, you know, I just say to my friends and my family says, if this can happen to us, it can happen to anybody. But yeah. It makes you really think twice because, like I said, he never went to bars on the weekend. If I count on five fingers, you know, I still have one or two left over when he did drink.
Yeah.
But the fact is he went out that day and had drinks. And I says, Joe didn't even have a driver's license because he had his taken away due to DWI many, many years ago. And I said to myself, if you two had drinks and you thought maybe they poured it too heavy, you should have called a cab. It was still your ultimate responsibility. So I'm not clearing you from this responsibility. Yeah.
Still, though, it's easy for people on the sidelines to be critical. Yeah, and ultimately, your daughter's a victim in all of this. And this is no longer your husband, right? You guys are divorced?
We are apart. We've been apart for 20-some years, but actually it's hard to say. We've been in the same house. He has his bedroom, I have mine. His girlfriend's four houses away.
Okay.
And I've had a boyfriend for 13 years.
Okay, that's
so
wild.
We've acted as a family, but not in a conventional sort of way.
You do see this happen with mothers and fathers who try to stay together in some way for the parents, right? Or for the children. For the children. I find that to be very interesting. Well, Michelle, that's wild, and ultimately, though, you support your daughter here, and it seems like you accomplished something in this matter.
I did, and I want to thank you for your hope.
All right, well, thanks so much, Michelle, and have a wonderful weekend, okay?
Thank you, you too. Yeah.
And, you know, you think about these split moments where an accident occurs. You had a cocktail, maybe that doesn't lend to the accident, but that the blood test shows, I mean, you could find yourself sitting in jail. I mean, it's really just horrible when you think about it. Must make all of us think the word Uber every once in a while might not be a bad idea.